Hello folks, this is Ayatan Ajha from InspireToRise.com, and sometimes in life, a big screen is just not enough for content consumption. You need a 4K HDR projector. Oh yeah. So guys, this is the BenQ TQ800 projector. This is a 4K HDR projector which is claimed to be amongst the best in its class. Today we are going to unbox and review this and tell you everything about it. And also we are going to tell you whether this is a good purchase at around $1,499, which is around 1 lakh Indian rupees or not. They say that this is a budget projector. Specifically, I can say that this is a budget projector for those looking for a 4K projector. Definitely a budget projector for those people. But otherwise, it's definitely an expensive purchase for a lot of people. Hold your horses down. I'm gonna tell you everything about it and whether it's a good buy or not. So guys, let's first unbox this one. Inside the box, what you get is the power cord for this one, remote control, the AAA battery, lens cover, user manual, CD, quick start guide, the warranty card and the works, and you get this projector itself. If I talk about few of the features, this projector comes with true 4K UHD 8.3 megapixel resolution. This projector comes with projector optimized HDR. HDR 10 support is there on this one. The brightness on this one is really good at around 3000 lumens, and it has a contrast ratio of 10,000:1. What does that mean? That means is that the bright areas on this one are really bright, and if you're somebody who's gonna use it with some ambient lighting, in that condition also this projector works really well. And if I talk about few of the features, it does come up with a lot of good things, and there are a lot of cons also. And but the cons make sense in the sort of price bracket that this projector sits in and the sort of feature set that it provides. So the first thing that you have to understand over here is the color space for this one. So this projector supports 92% REC709 color space, and it supports RGBW color wheels as opposed to RGB color wheels. What does that mean? That means is that the maximum brightness on this one goes a really high, tad bit up compared to other projectors. But what does that mean in the negative sense is that because of that RGBW color wheel, the overall number of colors are reduced. That does help when you're watching something in a lit room. Yes. Nice pun over there. And now let's talk about few other features. If I talk about the inbuilt speaker on this one, it comes with a 5-watt speaker, which is okay for a lot of things. But seriously, if you want good audio, you have to invest in something. Or otherwise, if you're somebody like me who's gonna watch alone in the office, then you can use a headphone. One of the cons that I found about this projector was the fact that when I turned on any of the custom modes, the sound came with a little bit of hissing, and it was not due to my headphones. I tested those headphones in other headsets also. It was perfectly fine. So there is a little bit of hissing sound problem in here, and I am not sure what exactly caused that or whether it was specific to my particular unit or not. If I talk about the build and design, it's pretty sturdy. There's a focus ring over here, zoom ring over here. You get the decent control options on the top. There's the eco mode switching option, the lamp option, power on option, temperature, LED lights, indicators, and everything else. At the back also, there are a sufficient number of ports, including one HDMI 1 port, one HDMI 2 port, mini B port. There's a type A port so that you can give power to something like a Google Chromecast or something. And other than that, there's the 12 volt trigger, Kensington lock port, and overall I feel that this is quite sturdily built for something which is a projector. Now, how can you mount it? You can use it on tabletop. So there are these adjustable screws at the bottom for adjusting the height. And then you can also mount it on the roof if you're somebody who's really into that sort of setup. And it's a versatile product for the kind of stuff that it does. Let's talk about the picture quality and clarity. So in order to proceed with my review, I had to have a HDR footage. And in order to test that, we used an Asus laptop, which was the TUF Gaming FX505, quite good laptop for 4K output. And on that laptop, we played Groundhog Day. It's one of my most favorite movies of all times. And we played the 4K HDR remastered version with the Dolby audio. What I found in my experience was that the output on the laptop itself was really dull because it was HDR and the laptop screen can't do justice to that high dynamic range. But when I chose the HDR option for this one and saw it on my wall, it was really good. My camera couldn't do justice to the kind of quality that I witnessed in front of me. It was really good. And by default, the lamp is set on the smart eco mode. I would suggest you to turn it to normal mode this increases the power consumption, but otherwise you would face sudden increases in the brightness, or maybe sometimes it would be dimmed in dark scene a lot, and that is a non-consistent experience. So I would suggest that you set the lamp to normal mode. And other than that, I think that this is a good projector for lit spaces, and it's a good projector for really dark spaces. Works really great up to like 135 inches or even more. But if you're gonna go really wide in terms of the projected output, there would be a light border on the corners, which is something that a lot of people might not like. And apart from that, if I talk about few other issues, the projector worked really fine. I didn't notice any heating or abnormal noises with this setup, even after watching a movie for around 2.5 hours or so. And if you talk about the built-in modes, it comes with the football mode preset selected by default, and I would personally recommend it because it's really bright and pushes the saturation a little bit more above the natural saturation levels. Some people like that. And then there's the cinema mode, which is really color accurate, but the overall brightness goes down, and I would suggest you to enable that cinema mode only if you are in a room with all of the lights off or a very dark place. Otherwise, that cinema mode tends to decrease the brightness by a huge measure. Personally, I would suggest a combination of the football mode along with you personally turning down the saturation a little bit and playing with the gamma and everything else. By default, BenQ applies their own gamma to this. There's an automated algorithm going on behind the back, but you can always adjust those things manually if you're really into that sort of thing. This one weighs around 4.2 kilograms and it's rated for 100 inches projection at 3.25 meters of distance. And the lamp is rated to have a life of 15,000 hours. So that means that it's rated to run flawlessly for that time duration. And after that, you might see issues and errors. Now, this projector does support 3D, but you need special 3D glasses in order to view that content. Now, for a price of around 1 lakh INR, would I suggest this one? So if you're somebody who really appreciates that 4K quality, are willing to bet high on HDR content, if you're somebody who's gonna have their own personal projector setup for really customized entertainment needs, or if you're somebody who's looking for really good picture quality without dropping a ton of cash on something like an OLED or something, then I would really suggest this, because of the fact that the picture quality on this one was amazing. And it also depends upon the kind of screen that you are projecting the output on. I've seen a lot of other people using this, and if you use really good acoustic screens, you can get really good outputs with the blacks and details more pronounced. And I was using this just on my plain white wall, this wall, specific wall behind me. So it doesn't really do justice to the kind of quality that this projector can output. But personally, I feel that this is a great buy for someone looking to invest in a 4K projector for the long term. This projector comes with better brightness than most of its competitors, and if I talk about the total number of colors, somewhere it does fall behind few of the competing models. But if you talk about brightness and contrast ratio in general, this specific model wins, because it has 3000 lumens of brightness, and a lot of them have around 2200 or 2500 lumens of brightness, and that really does not cut it when you are in a place which is well lit. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. Do subscribe to Inspire to Rise for more awesome tech videos like this one. And guys, there's a bell icon down there. Don't forget to hit it. And no matter what you do, stay inspired.